Welcome back to another Google AdMob tutorial. Today, I'll be taking you through the first part of our three-part Firebase A/B testing series for AdMob. In this first edition, we will be focusing on the basics of Firebase A/B testing and best practices for using AdMob and Firebase together. First, we will be explaining what A/B testing is and how it can help you earn more with AdMob. Then, we will explain the methodology behind experimentation. We will be exploring questions like, does changing X improve metric Y? And run you through the experiment lifecycle. Next, we will explain how to set up Firebase A/B testing with remote config in Firebase. Then, we will show you how to use A/B testing and remote config together to set up the optimal experiments in Firebase. And finally, we will provide some recommendations for the ideal duration of an A/B test and how you can best measure success to solidify your business cases with A/B testing. Firebase A/B testing has several benefits. For instance, you can use this tool to allow for easy setup, saving engineering time and resources. With Firebase A/B testing, we take care of the infrastructure work and all at no cost to you. Once your app is set up with remote config and analytics, anyone in your organization can create, run, and analyze their own experiments without draining your engineering resources. Allow teams to test experimental features on a small number of users. Easily enable new features from successful experiments or remotely disable them if they are unsuccessful. A/B testing is used when there is more than one approach for doing a task, and you have a feeling that one of those approaches is better than the others. To find the best approach, you will need to gather data and measure the outcome. Some scenarios where this may occur include changing a feature and measuring if it has a negative or positive effect on user behavior, adding a new feature and determining which variation of the new feature works best. In each of these scenarios, you are comparing two variations of your app, version A and version B, in a head-to-head test to see which produces the best results. Now, let's go a little more in-depth on how to set up an A/B experiment. The essential question that you should be asking here is, does changing X improve metric Y? To answer this question, we recommend going through the experiment lifecycle. This is a step-by-step process to help ensure that you get to the most accurate X and Y. The experiment lifecycle consists of the following steps. Number one, plan your experiment by formalizing your hypothesis. A great example would be Pomelo Games. They wanted to see if they could increase the profitability of their game. Their hypothesis was that showing interstitial ads to their users would improve their revenue without impacting their user experience. When designing your own A/B test, you also want to make sure you can form a hypothesis that one variant could outperform another two. Number two, wire up your app to deliver different experiment variants. In our example from Pomelo Games, they created two variants targeted to a subset of their users. One variant showed interstitial ads to users, and the other did not. Now, they needed a way to distribute the two variants out to their users. Luckily, Firebase Remote Config and Firebase A/B testing could easily do that part for them. Number three, define experiment in your AdMob and Firebase UI. Number four, run the experiment on your target or intended population. Number five, review the results. Returning to our example from Pomelo Games, after running their experiment, they found that their change increased revenue by 35% without losing any players. Happy with their results, they rolled out the variant with the changes to all their players. If their experiment had failed, they could have easily rolled back the changes. To make running A/B tests even easier, Remote Config in Firebase lets you set up test conditions to specify which users you want to include in your test without having to update your app. You can essentially change the behavior and appearance of the app based on conditions you can define in the Firebase console, like users who speak a specific language, are on a specific platform, or part of a random percentile of your total user base, all without requiring an app update. Some of the key benefits of Remote Config include progressively testing and rolling out new features, for example, new ad formats or placements. Making real-time changes to the app without the need for an app update. Controlling text, URLs, keys, and other static assets remotely. and providing different parameter values to different user segments or audiences. Remote Config is a free service with no DAU or MAU caps and serves more than 1 billion requests per day. Remote Config is easy to set up. Simply wire up variables in your app to use Remote Config parameter values and proceed to make a fetch call to receive those values in your app. Remote Config seamlessly integrates with other Firebase products and Google Analytics as well. This means that you can adjust app behavior for segments identified by your analytics audiences, like purchasers, your beginner level gamers, or Firebase predictions user segments like users predicted to churn or predicted to spend. You should only use testing if you have a hypothesis that some variant is better than the current default. Put together your experiment using Firebase by generating a targeting condition and allocating desired percentages to your target and control groups. We'll dive deeper into how to build target and control groups in the next video. Also, for specific instructions on how you can set up A/B testing in your iOS and Android apps, check out the Firebase video series on using AdMob and Firebase together. It'll walk through testing different ad strategies and implementing them in your app. The link will be attached in the description box below. Once your results reach a desired confidence level, you can decide what you would like to do with the experiment. If one of the experiment variants is outperforming the control, you can decide to roll it out as the new control in the Firebase console. If the confidence level of the experiment results reaches 95% or greater, you'll also receive an email indicating that there is a likely winner in your experiment. At any point, you can choose whether or not to terminate the experiment, but if the confidence level isn't high enough yet, you'll probably want to wait to gather more data. If there is a clear winner during the experiment, you'll be given the option to roll out that winning variant in the Firebase console. Rolling out the variant means giving every user who was targeted in your experiment the same values as the winning variant. If you only targeted a small portion of your users and now want all of your users to get the same parameter values as your winning variant, you can just end the experiment and edit your remote config parameters to use the winning variant values and update the condition to target all users in your app. Now that you know how to put together an A/B test, a natural question that follows would be, well, how long do I run this test for then? The general rule of thumb would be a minimum of 14 days, but this is contingent upon determining a variant as the leader. Some experiments do end up running for longer. These scenarios happen when there is a desire to measure persistent, long-term effects versus transient effects, for example, seasonality or novelty effects, or there's a desire to collect a larger sample to reduce uncertainty of results. Finally, now that you have worked out the mechanics of your A/B test and the time needed, how can you determine if your A/B test has been successful? Always ensure that your results are measurable and meaningful. We recommend you run a test on the best performing ads with AdMob. To start, pick an event or metric that is ads oriented. For example, ad impression event count or ad revenue. Or if you're trying to determine different text for a new dialog box, measuring positive or negative engagements would help you determine the better candidate. And that's all we have for the first part of our Firebase series. To summarize the key takeaways of this video, engage with Firebase A/B testing because it allows you to make changes seamlessly. With Remote Config, you can change the behavior and appearance of your app without going through an app update. 14 days is a general rule of thumb for experiments' duration contingent upon determining a variant as the leader. Once again, thank you for watching Google AdMob tutorials. We hope you have learned a thing or two about Firebase A/B testing and how to better implement an A/B test within your app. But before you jump off, we have more resources to share down by the description box to make your A/B testing journey a smoother one. You can find resources such as the developer's guide for both Android and iOS just right below the video description. And one last thing, be sure to subscribe to the Google AdMob channel for more best practices and tips on how you can grow your app further.